反對咧，即係我哋早少少隻。
All right, if there is no objection, let's resume the meeting 2 minutes earlier than any objection. All right, if not, meetings is resumed. We have a number of members waiting to ask questions. First round, we have Mr. Ray Chan. Thank you, Chairman. In Annex D of the paper, there is a chronology of, or there is a indicative timeline. And then, before granting support in principle by the Seeing Council, the central team will vet the application, and I suppose it's a team of civil servants. And then there will be consultation with panel of advisors. However, I don't see anything about consulting the district councils as representatives of the people or consulting the public. Is the panel of advisors responsible for consulting the district councils? If it is aware of the application and also strong objections or strong views from the community, will the DCs be invited to exchange views with the panel? Say, well, I don't know whether it should be the central team or panel of advisors. How about whether it is possible for the district councils to invite them to come and exchange views? Will they attend? Thank you for the question. As I replied before, say we have a central team of professionals in the civil service and also panel of advisors being consulted before the matters forwarded to the Seeing Council, say for a rezoning proposal, departments will also offer the comments in a traditional town planning process. And the public will be allowed to inspect the proposal. And the same applies to what happens here. The DCs as well as the town planning board will have to go through some procedures, and the public will also be invited to attend the TPB hearing, including district councillors. Views collected will be made public. Well, I can't answer on behalf of the central team as to how the views will be handled, but that's the case. As for the district council's mechanism, definitely there will be views collected for the town planning board to consider. Of course, we understand under the existing mechanism, the town planning board considers public's views and district council's views. I want to point out that under the LSPS, if at the earliest stage you can collect views from the community, and that say if there are strong views from the community, if there is a channel is available at the earliest stage for better communication, it would be better. Some 20 deputations and individuals expressed their views, and I'd like to highlight two main points for you and Secretary. First, protecting farmland or quality farmland. I believe you will take this into serious consideration under the LSPS. Second, about infrastructure. Usually, infrastructure is designed to meet the needs of development projects. Say the new territories. If you take a look at the blueprint or the vision and the overall direction of development in the area, and I think we need to place more emphasis, because when we talk about infrastructure under the LSPS, it is a response, a kind of support for the project to be made possible. And this is just like what I said just now. It gives a perception that the infrastructure is there to help the project, but at the same time, you should emphasize that there is a blueprint. For example, in the new territories, some parts are not included even in the OZPs. So I'm suggesting, Secretary, that you give it a thought.
Well, I don't need any answer from you. The next round, three members, I've drawn the line. And after three members have asked their questions, I will deal with Mr. Choitik's amendment, Mr. Choitik's motion. Mr. Lok, 2 minutes. I think a person who is related to developers said that the developers may not have interest. I understand that the developers want to get more benefits. They want the scheme should be more favorable to the developers. I think that's unfair to the public. Now, this is the way they attempt to do so. Give me more favors so that I will join the scheme. I want to ask the administration how as to how they respond to that. And I want to advise the secretary. Can you tell the market that if the developers continue to hoard up to hoard land and try to get extravagant profits, then the government will be more active in resuming land. The government will consider more actively using the land resumption ordinance, the pass under the land resumption ordinance. I thank Mr. Luke for his view. Well, I want to make 2 points. If the LSPS is a voluntary scheme, we will not penalize them if they don't join the scheme. But you need to send them a message. The argument for the scheme is to make use of market forces. I have given the numbers. I will not repeat them. We are active in resuming land. We plan first and then we develop afterwards. If land has development potential and there is no development, and if our public objective is to provide public housing, then we resume land. As for the scheme per se, there is no penalty if you don't join the scheme. Next, Mr. Lau Kwok Fun. In the first round, I asked the Development Bureau to talk to the AFCD. There are 4,000-odd hectares which are farmland. The demand may not be so big. There is a need to support farming, and there is a need to do planning on this. Now, according to your own estimate, how many hectares of land can you turn from greenfield sites into sites that can be developed? Many people support the development at the NDAs, and they are willing to hand over their squatter huts earlier. Therefore, can you speed up the development process? Say, for example, you have two stages of development, and those who are included in the second stage, who are willing to hand over their sites to you, then you will speed up the process of development. I just want to know, how much capacity do you have in processing land? There is no scientific data to answer the question. For NT North, there are about 700-odd hectares for development. We have started the Loma Chau Santin study, if I may continue. And we are studying Yuen Long South, and we've completed Kutong North, Fanling North, and Hong Sui Kiu planning. It's not just government resources. If you want to make some large-scale changes, then you need to consider the capacity of the community. Now we are doing our best, and if there is a large-scale rezoning, after the completion rezoning, we need to do land resumption, and we may need to do some relocation or resettlement. We are working on Kutong North and Fanling North. Say if those who are living there want to leave earlier, then we are willing to process their case earlier. But can we develop the sites so handovered? Not so, because we need to develop the area phase by phase. Mr. Ji Hoi-dek, I really hope that the Town Planning Board can be the gatekeeper for quality farmland. According to the report on biodiversity, they said that between 2012 to 2016, planning application for farmland, as far as that is concerned, 60% of the application involving farmland for rezoning have been approved by the Town Planning Board. So the LSPS should set a more stricter standard so that farmland will not be damaged. The Secretary may worry that there is a duplication of effort if LSPS is put before the District Council of Consultation, and when the same project is put before the Town Planning Board, the District Council is consulted again. I want to ask the District Councillors who are present, if the LSPS is put before the District Council for consultation and have got the endorsement of the District Council, then when it comes to the Town Planning Board, there is no need for that project to be put before the District Council. I hope Mr. Leung will answer the question. Yes, I think that is very good. If you go to the departments first before going to the District Council, then you may not be able to understand people's reaction. And if people have strong reactions, then the technical departments will have to change their plan and the developers will have to change their plan. If the CE wants to step up communication with District Council, I think this proposal is good. The Secretary, I have no further points to make. We are going to iron out the details. If I accept Mr. Chu's will, we will explain that. All right, so much for the public hearing for today, and I draw a line there for the public hearing. Thank you very much for attending the meeting. Public hearing. I will now have to deal with the proposal by Mr. Chu Hoi-dek and amendment by Mr. Lau Kok-fun. Please ring the bell. Thank you. Would members please take your seat? Yes, please take your seat. Please take your seats. So what motion are we dealing with? Now, first of all, I have to ask members whether we are to deal with the amendment, the motion amendment, Mr. Joydick's motion. If members agree to deal with Mr. Chu's motion, then I will have to deal with Mr. Lau's amendment. And if Mr. Lau's amendment is endorsed, then we will not deal with Mr. Joydick's original amendment, original motion. All right. I will extend the meeting at most by 15 minutes. I ask you to go back to your seat to facilitate the clock, because we're going to have a division.
So I need to ask members whether you agree to proceed with Mr. Eddie Chu's motion. As I explained just now, if we agree, then we should vote on the amendment proposed by Mr. Lau Guofan. Any objection? This is just about dealing with that motion. All right, we all agree. So I don't need to claim a division, and then we can now vote on Mr. Lau Guofan's amendment to the motion. Are we in favor? Mr. Lau Guofan, would you please read out the motion? To genuinely balance the need between development and conservation, we urge the government to expeditiously complete the study on agricultural priority areas whilst implementing the land sharing pilot scheme to protect quality farmland. Do we need to claim a division? Right, so I don't need to ring the quorum bell if we have a quorum here. Just a show of hands, please. Those in favor? Those in favor, please raise your hand. Just stay there and let me jot down the names, and then you can put your hand down. Those in favor, Dr. Priscilla Leung, Dr. Loai Kwok, Mrs. Regina Ip, Ms. Alice Mack, Mr. Michael Look, Deputy Chair, Mr. Wilson Orr, Ms. Dari Lee, Mr. Vincent Chang, Ms. Chan Ho Yan, Ms. Lo Kok Fan. Those against, please raise your hand. Please wait. We need to jot down your names. Those against the motion, Mr. Andrew Wen, Mr. Lam Chok Ting, Dr. Fernando Zhang, Mr. Ray Chan, Mr. Eddie Ju, Mr. Cheng Chong Tai, Dr. Helena Wong, Ms. Tanya Chan, Mr. Alvin Yang. So 10 members in favor and 9 members against. Any abstention? I suppose everybody voted already. All right, we have 10 votes in favor and 9 votes against. The motion is passed. Now, the motion is passed, so we don't need to deal with Mr. Eddie Ju's motion. So the meeting is adjourned here. No AOB. All right, meeting is adjourned.